Thank you. Good evening, Kasson-Mantorville families. Thank you so much for joining us this evening in our wonderful Wi-Fi Performing Arts Center, Minnesota Wi-Fi Performing Arts Center. We are really excited for our 7th grade, 8th grade, and behind me our rock and jazz band here to feature some wonderful music tonight. Before we begin, students, let's make sure we are demonstrating respect in all that we do. Right, phones are off, hats are off. We are respecting our classmates as they perform in front of you. Families, let's not forget to make sure that we turn off our ringers. Certainly feel free to take pictures of your children or grandchildren or whoever they are. Enjoy tonight, and I want to especially thank Mrs. Harwood and Mrs. Van Zandt for all of their dedication, hard work. Yes. There's so much time and effort that is put into a concert like this, and the students and families as well, thank you for allowing your children to participate in band. So, without further ado, please welcome Miss Harwood.
All right, so I'm really excited to get started with our rock and jazz band. We've met maybe only four times. We have one piece prepared for you tonight. It's Feliz Navidad. And since we have just the one piece, I told the students if they wanted to wear Santa hats or reindeer antlers or anything like that, they sure could. So of course, on my way out the door, I'm like, do we have a Santa hat out yet? And all of our Christmas decorations, except for the lights, are still up in storage. And so we went into the costume bucket really fast, and this is the one that I have to share with you today. So here we go. Oh no, it's too little. It doesn't even fit. Oh, there we go. It's stuck. We're good. Here we go. Feliz Navidad.
Thank you. All right, good evening, everyone. My name is Sarah VanZant, and I'm very excited to get to share the seventh grade band with you tonight. This group has been working on some very fun and very difficult music. The first piece that we're going to start our concert off with is very fast and technical. It is called Emerald Point Overture by Anne McGinty.
Thank you.
Oh, there we go. I was like, did I do something wrong? All right. One of the cool things about our seventh grade band this year is that we have a very, very large percussion section. And actually tonight we're unfortunately down two of our percussionists due to illness. But regardless, this year I wanted to pick something that could really showcase some of the unusual side of the percussion section. So this next piece is a familiar tune. It helps our students learn in a new time signature called 6/8, and it also features various whistles and horns. In particular, it features, for you hunters out there, it features a duck call, which if you would like to ask your seventh grader about a very long story that involved Mr. Bolt, Mr. Faller, a duck call, and Music Mart trying to get it to us, we had picture-perfect timing this morning with our duck call. So make sure to listen out for that. Please enjoy this next selection, The Addams Family. So our seventh grade band is not only full of talented musicians, but it's also great to be able to showcase our students' other talents. Notably, Hazel Campbell out of our clarinet section, Hazel, if you can stand, actually submitted the design for the cover of our program. So if we could give Hazel a round of applause, please. And then our next piece, I wanted to utilize some of our students' speaking skills. We have such a strong theater program here at KM, as many of you saw with our recent musical. So I would like to invite Hannah, Gabby, Leah, and Asher forward to read portions of the poem that our next piece is designed after.
I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on higher vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils.
Besides the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. Continuous as the stars that shine and twinkle on the Milky Way, they stretch in a never-ending line along the margin of a bay.
10,000 I saw at a glance, tossing their heads in a sprightly dance.
For oft, when on a couch I lie, in vacant or in pensive mood, they flash upon that inward eye which is the bliss of solitude. For them my heart with pleasure fills and dances with the daffodils.
All right, so this next piece needs a lot of explaining. So Randall Sandridge is a very famous composer in the band world, and he writes that it's actually very difficult to compose holiday music because there's only a certain number of tunes that are both familiar and in public domain. So he writes, "So enters Santa the Barbarian." Randall says in this work, "I have reimagined the jolly old elf as a warrior of the winter wastes. The familiar tunes of Up on the Housetop and Jingle Bells are transformed into a war cry for this incarnation of Santa as he navigates the snowy desert with his eight mighty reindeer, Basher, Danger, Lancer, Victim, Bomet, Brutus, my personal favorite, Runner, and Blitz Them. On Christmas night, he flies his way across the unforgiving terrain in time to bring toys to all the good children, leaving a path of destruction and candy cane carnage in his wake." So he ends it with "Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays from me to you and yours." So this next piece has a very important narration at the beginning of it. Please welcome to the stage our famous KM actor, Mr. Kasson Siegel. Wherever he is.
When the winter winds blew in an age long ago, and the Yuletide season brought the darkness and snow. They told of a gift giver in tombs antiquarian. From the far icy waste he comes, Santa the Barbarian!
The microphone dropping made it extra spooky. I was not expecting that. Of course, we can't end the holiday season with yelling at you with Santa hats. So we have one final piece tonight to kind of lift our spirits and set our sights towards the holiday season. But before that, I want to give an extra special thank you to both Cody, our technical director, and Kasson, who put in quite a bit of time and energy figuring out how to make Santa the Barbarian extra spooky for our students. After the conclusion of our final piece, seventh graders, you'll be returning back to your reserved seats to watch the eighth grade band. There'll be a little transition, and we'll let them take the stage. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Oh, I bet this is Kasson's notes. Okay.
All right, before we begin the eighth grade portion of the concert, I just want to let you know that next Friday night, if you're not in the mood to cook, if you're not in the mood to cook dinner, we're going to host a burger fry at the Legion. If you've ever had their burgers, they're really quite fantastic. I know quite a while ago, I roped my husband into running the grill, so I'm going to go home and remind him of that really quick, and then we'll have some great burgers and fries on Friday night at the Legion if you're interested. I think they also, you can get things to go if you want to do that as well. It's a great fundraiser for the band, helps support all of the instruments and things that are not covered by our regular school budget. And as our program has grown and grown and grown, of course, we've needed more and more instruments. Right now, I'm like somehow managing to think about how we're going to buy a couple of tubas and several French horns. I'm in the market, so if you know of someone, just, you know, let me know. But Burger Fry on Friday night, next Friday night. Hope you can be there. All right, let's get the show on the road.
In the southern hemisphere, really? Being annoying.
Yeah. There you go.
In the southern hemisphere, directly above the Tropic of Capricorn, lies a constellation called Capricornus. In the zodiac, it is also known as the sea goat, and has been depicted from earliest times as being a goat in its top half and a fish on its lower half.
I did not mean to laugh. Okay. I got it really tight. Okay. I'm sorry, Olivia.
This is a great opener for our concert, filled with the driving, relentless energy at the beginning that fades into a beautiful tonal section, then ends with a recap of the high energy aggressive coda. We hope you enjoy Capricorn Moon.
No matter what our cultural background, the holiday season is the time of year where we reflect upon the joys in our lives. During those very quiet and reflective moments, we experience peace that allows us to recognize all that is good in our beautiful world. All Is Calm features multiple soloists in our band and celebrates the beauty and joys of our holiday season.
That felt just slightly like, how many band directors does it take to change a light bulb, didn't it? Just a little bit? Okay.
Thank you. The composer of our next piece is Adrian Sims, a young leading composer. Here are his words that describe our next piece. Set deep within a magical forest, this short, adventurous work set in 6/8 compound meter seeks mischief in the woods. The music walks a careful line between excitement and danger as we lurk upon the shadows of the night, stealthily moving through the woodland. We finally see the shadows in a magnificent and beautiful dance upon, measure 93. Sorry, guys. Reaching measure 93. Upon being noticed, we dash out of the forest and escape unscathed. A thrilling and enchanted adventure.
I am very excited to be a part of the Kasson-Mantorville community. One of the things that I love is how supportive the parents are, the teachers are, that we work with at the middle school and at the high school, the staff that's here. The custodians are just so kind and so helpful whenever we need something. I especially appreciate Cody Rashavi, who not only helped us with all the projections and lighting and everything. Mrs. Vinzant and I throw out suggestions, and then he's like, sure, we'll do this and that. And it turns out really super cool every time. He also hung the festive lights on the top border of our stage, which is really fun, and appreciate that very much. So thank you very much, Cody, in particular. I would also like to take a moment to thank Mr. Bolt. In addition to jumping in and covering some of Mr. Fowler's classes this morning, he also helped set everything up. Just yesterday morning, the custodians put the stage back on the front part here, which made for a very, very fast setup, trying to get everything pulled together today. So thank you very much to Mr. Bolt, Mr. Fowler, J.J. Williams, and his custodial crew as well. Thank you very, very much to all three of them. In addition to Kasson Siegel helping with Santa the Barbarian and sounding absolutely barbaric, thank you. We also had him running the lights and such, and the audio, I believe. And then Savannah Potter is running the live stream today. So thank you very much to Kasson and Savannah. You guys are the best. And last but absolutely not least, thank you so much to Mr. Larson, to Mrs. Simon, to Mr. Isbell, to Mrs. Boudin, to all of the folks who make this happen, and to you, the parents. Thank you so much. We appreciate your help and assistance. When we email you, you're the best. Thank you. You make our jobs great. Now, this past summer, I was very fortunate. My family and I took a trip out east, and when we actually got a chance, we got to walk in and see the Liberty Bell, the actual Liberty Bell in Pittsburgh. And right past the Liberty Bell, behind the Liberty Bell, they have this glass wall, and then you can see Declaration Hall, where the Declaration of Independence was signed. And it was just a fantastic experience to be there with my family. Of course, you all know how much I love a good joke, and so I can't pass up telling one good joke tonight. Well, actually, I found quite a few, but every single one of them was so good, they all just, you know, all the jokes about the Liberty Bell, they just cracked me up. All right. I know, you guys especially. They love the cheesy jokes. All right, here we go. Thank you so much.